Hello everyone, welcome to Semicon Talk. Today's topic is worldwide fab capacity. Let's talk about it. Wafer fab is a factory to make semiconductor chips using wafer, and it is a very complex and super expensive facility. For 200mm wafer fab, the number of companies who have their own wafer fab was 76 in 2007, and that was the maximum number. Then, it is decreased to 63 now. For 300mm wafer fab, 29 companies had their own wafer fab in 2008, and that was the maximum number. Then, it is 28 now. Wafer fab is very expensive, so usually only limited companies can have their own wafer fab. Especially for advanced silicon node with 300mm wafer, it costs multi-billion dollars. This is the wafer fab capacity leader share change between 2009 and 2020. In 2009, top 5 wafer capacity companies took 36% of worldwide capacity, and top 10 took 54%, top 15 took 64%, and top 25 took 78%. But in 2020, top 5 wafer capacity companies took 54% of worldwide capacity, and it is much more than 36% in 2009. And top 10 took 70%, top 15 took 79%, and top 25 took 89%. It means worldwide wafer capacity is concentrated on fewer companies in 2020 than 2009. This is the wafer capacity by region at December 2020. Number one is Taiwan. There are foundries like TSMC, UMC, and IDMs like Nanya, Micron. Taiwan has 21.4% of worldwide wafer fab capacity, and it is expected to remain the largest region for wafer capacity through 2025. Number two is Korea with 20.4%. Samsung and SK Hynix continue to aggressively expand their fab to support their DRAM and NAND memory. Number 3 is Japan with 15.8%, and number 4 is China with 15.3%. But it is expected that China will surpass Japan in 2021. Number 5 is the North America with 12.6%, and number 5 is Europe with 5.7%. What kinds of silicon node is the major portion of wafer fab capacity by region? For the most advanced silicon node less than 10 nanometer, only Taiwan and Korea have capacity. Taiwan has 21% of their capacity for less than 10 nanometers and 18% for 10 to 20 nanometers and so on. Korea has 13% of their capacity for less than 10 nanometers and 57% for 10 to 20 nanometers. Japan has 57%. North America has 36%. China has 39%. And Europe has 11% of their capacity for 10 to 20 nanometers. The second advanced silicon node technology in this graph. Here is a list of top 5 fab capacity companies in 2020. Number 1 is Samsung from Korea. Number 2 is TSMC from Taiwan. Number 3 is Micron from North America. Number 4 is SK Hynix from Korea. Number 5 is Kioxia and Western Digital from Japan. Kioxia and Western Digital are talking about M&A. After top 5, wafer capacity at other semiconductor leaders quickly fall off. Following companies are Intel with 884K wafers per month, UMC with 772K wafers per month, GlobalFoundries, Texas Instruments, and SMIC. This is logic wafer fab capacity breakdown by location for the most advanced silicon node less than 10 nanometers. In 2021, Taiwan takes 55%, Korea is following with 20%, and US with 18%. In 2025, it will be 44% for Taiwan, 19% for Korea, and 21% for US. For US portion, Intel's Arizona fab expansion and new fabs in US by TSMC, Samsung will contribute. In 2027, combining capacity of Taiwan and Korea is still 57% of global capacity. This is logic wafer fab capacity breakdown by silicon node for less than 10 nanometers. It will be increased from 2021 to 2025. 2027 with 21% CAGR, compound annual growth rate. And major companies will be TSMC, Samsung, and Intel. TSMC plans to invest $100 billion over the next 3 years. It includes $12 billion fab in Arizona, USA, which will be 5nm using EUV technology. Its construction is ongoing now. They also plan to spend $2.8 billion for Fab 16 in Nanjing, China, and it'll be used for expansion of its output to 40,000 wafers per month by middle of 2023. TSMC has planned to build specialty fab in Japan with Sony as well. Samsung has $151 billion investment plan through 2030. It includes $17 billion fab in USA, and location will be Texas, Arizona, or New York. $47 billion fab in Korea is under construction and will be completed in second half of 2022. This new fab in Korea will produce 14nm DRAM and 5nm logic with EUV lithography technology. Intel has $100 billion investment plan for next 10 years. It includes two new fabs in Chandler, Arizona, USA, and Intel broke ground last month in September 2021. Its estimated cost is $20 billion and will be ready for production in 2024. Thanks for watching and have a nice day. Bye-bye.